Yesterday, Conservatives in West Berkshire chose their candidate for the election, so now we have a full set of candidates who'd like to be the new MP for Newbury. This morning on The Peach Show, as part of our election 2019 coverage, we're going to meet them. Laura Farris is standing for the Conservatives. Morning, Laura.
Good morning, Andrew.
Congratulations on getting chosen yesterday.
Thank you.
Let's just talk a little bit. I mean, there's quite a lot of cosy stuff with you and Richard Bennion, the previous MP, on social media yesterday. Do you agree with what Richard Bennion did, which is to give control of the House of Commons to Jeremy Corbyn in order to pass legislation which made the Boris Johnson's life a whole lot more difficult? Do you think that was the right thing for him to do?
I'm a big supporter of Richard Bennion. I think he's been a fantastic public servant for Newbury. I would vote differently to Richard on that. I said in my selection speech last night, my pledge to Newbury is I'm going to be supporting the government on every vote to take us out of the European Union. And I look forward to one of my first votes, hopefully being to pass Boris's withdrawal bill.
Right. So would that be fairly paraphrased as Richard Bennion was a bit of a Remainer and I'm a proper Leaver?
I wouldn't put it like that. I really, really want to move beyond the language of Remain and Leave. I think it's time to drop that language and actually get things moving. Look, I've said how I'm going to vote and I'm absolutely pledged to do so.
Right, so you're not going to be rebelling in any way against the Conservatives in the way that Richard Bennion hasn't for most of his time as a Member of Parliament, but certainly has a few times in the last year or so.
Well, I think that when you're elected on a Conservative manifesto, you know, when people put a cross by your name, they do so because they're expecting you to, you know, to abide by Conservative policies, and it's the policies they're putting in. So I would support them, but that doesn't mean I don't think there's plenty of room for reservation and enthusiasm and personality as an MP. And if I ever have to stand up for my constituency, I won't be afraid to do so.
No. Do you have reservations about leaving the EU? Because Newbury obviously voted to remain in the European Union, so it would be fair to surmise that a lot of people in the constituency have big reservations about it.
I understand those reservations. And actually, I think that's why I support the Prime Minister's bill, because, you know, having an implementation period, guaranteeing citizens' rights, having agreements on transport and travel and so on are actually really important for smoothing our exit to the European Union. We're never going to be able to please the Remainers by leaving, but I think what we owe to them is a smooth transition that protects business and jobs as much as possible.
We'll come back for more with Laura Farris, who's standing for the Conservatives, in a moment. 8:20 Monday morning. What was your pitch, Laura? You've been had a career as a lawyer. What was the winning argument that you made to get you this selection rather than your opponents?
Well, I did talk about the things I've seen in my career, and I also talked about my local links and the fact that my dad was the MP for Newbury from 1974 to 1992, but he died when I was a very young child. So it was quite an emotional moment, actually.
Right. So this was, for people who don't remember all this this history of Conservatives in West Berkshire, it was a Conservative seat, and then there was a by-election, and then the Liberal Democrats held the seat for a long time, and it took Richard Bennion many elections to win it back, and he's now been part of the tapestry of Conservative politics in West Berkshire for a long time. You're trying to take that on. So there's a whole dynasty going on here.
Well, I don't know a dynasty because, it's been a long time since I had any direct link. But I was born and I grew up in the constituency and I live just north of Newbury now. So it's an incredible honour, actually, because I love this place. It's my home.
Do you worry that, you know, we're seeing at this election many, many members of parliament stepping down, and we're seeing a lot of female members of parliament stepping down saying, look, this is no job for any human being to have to do at the moment because of the level of difficulty and abuse involved in the whole thing? Do you worry what you're getting yourself into if you're successful?
Andrew, I do think there's been a kind of coarsening of the political debate, actually, but I don't think this is the first moment we've had really difficult times in politics. I think there were difficult times around the poll tax, the miners' strike, and I did fight a seat in London at the last election, and I got my share of abuse then. So I've got a thick skin, but I have to say I do think there is a coarsening of the political debate, and I think it's really regrettable, actually, that people can't express views without having to put a hard hat on.